Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker. And I'm just here with a bit of an old Imperious Impressions? Question mark? On that there consuming shadow. This might be a Imperious Impressions, it might be a Redoubtable Revisitation. Actually, no, I think this would be a Redoubtable Revisitation. Which, by the way, is still my favourite name of any series I've ever come up with. Not my favourite series, don't make many of them, but Redoubtable Revisitation. That was a... I had to reach for that fucking name. But yes, The Consuming Shadow. You may be wondering, Sideways, or Ethan, depending on how formal or informal you're feeling today, why are you making another video on The Consuming Shadow? Didn't you make a Let's Play in which you basically spent about 9 videos failing at this game? Didn't you already do an Imperious Impressions of it, or a Sideways Shenanigans of it once? Yes. However, right now, I am playing the release version of The Consuming Shadow. Every video I've made on The Consuming Shadow thus far has been on the pre-release beta, the free version. This is a version of the game proper, the finished product released. I don't think it's out yet. This is review code, you know, full disclosure. This is a review copy that I got. But it's coming out, I think, on the 28th. I want to say Tuesday. The dude told me in the email, it's got all the details, should have checked the email, but pretty sure it's coming out on the 28th. I think there's going to be two versions of it. There's going to be one version that's going to be $10, which is just the basic game. Then there's going to be a $16, maybe $17 version that comes with the full game, and I think ebooks of two of Yahtzee's books. Although I think he's only written two. I think there's Mogworld and Jam. I've read Mogworld. If you're interested, Mogworld is a very good book. Haven't read Jam, but I've actually ordered a copy of it recently, so there you go. Anyway, yeah. So yeah, that's going to be up for $17. I think you have to buy it all from the actual Consuming Shadow website. Although a Steam... there is going to be a Steam Greenlight page made. And if this gets on Steam, I'm buying it on Steam. Like, I'd love to play this. So I've played it briefly. I haven't played it massively, and right away, like, immediately, there's a fair few changes. You know, right here, basic start screen, what have we got? What's new? Well, files and diary. The files here are, as far as I can tell, just Big Bertha, are literally like, it's like a bestiary that you complete as you play the game. There are 20 monsters in the game, 20 different kinds of monsters, and as you kill them, the percentage of each entry on them gets a bit more filled out. For example, you see here the spitter, you can see here, you know, the first part, because I've only got 30% of that cleared out, you know, some of it's been opened up, not massively, indeed some of this picture has even been opened up, but you see on the coffer, empty, the co, you see smaller and smaller, like tiny amounts of stuff that you just, it just increases per kill. It's quite fun. Then you also have the diary. In the various dungeons in this game, you can occasionally find diary pages as opposed to notes. Now, the diaries, so far as I can tell, don't actually have anything particularly to do with that particular game. Indeed, you can't even look at them inside that particular game. You know, that run, as far as I can tell. But, you know, when you come out, you can read them. There's a bunch of pages. You just find them randomly, you find them out of order as well, and I imagine as you piece them together, a puzzle will emerge. It may have some effect on the game entire, may give you some more backstory. In fact, I'm almost certain it's going to give you a backstory on what's actually going on in The Consuming Shadow. Now, we're going to begin a journey. Bear in mind that this is only my second go through this, and yeah, rather than the standard skill point stuff, that I failed with in the pre-release build, this game gives you birth stars for each level you get, and you can see here the birth stars, you can place them anywhere in the night sky. You can even place them like here, where there's absolutely no relevance, or you can place them within various constellations that will have an effect on your stats. So it's all about finding the best place to put it. There was one that was really good. Maybe if I put it like here so I can get the best of... Actually, I'm gonna put one... Okay, I'm gonna put one... Right here. So get a bunch of stuff there, and then I'm gonna just... You know, I'm actually going to massively up my sanity, because sanity is still one of the most difficult things to try to get back. So there we go. We got two of those. We got faster car, better research, and more sanity. Okay, here we go. Now, again, as you can see, immediately, the game looks better. You know, the car looks nicer. There's kind of slightly, it's a slightly different hood. You got all this. This is slightly different. It's actually got a spell book. It's got notes. It's got this. You've got specific equip slots that you can actually have. You have to pick what you want to equip. You don't just equip everything. You got your notes. You can actually delete clues if they become pointless. Like, say, if you got two clues that say the same thing in order to keep track of things. So I was just moving in my chair there. You can actually delete clues that aren't relevant. That is actually one of my problems with it. I'll get to that in a bit. You've even got this. Which basically, because some of you may recall, if you watched my Let's Play of the beta of Consuming Shadow, I actually had to have a notebook on my lap, basically to serve this purpose. To, you know, connect the dots between the three gods that are involved. Which is quite cool. You know, which was kind of cool. But now the game has systemized that. It's not going, it doesn't automatically fill in. You still have to, like, clicky, 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 you know, in order to get it to work. But it's really fun that the fact that, you know, this has been added. Not sure I've mentioned this, but there are several playable characters. I haven't unlocked any of them. I believe there are four in total with, as the game describes it, varying different play styles. I do intend on making more videos on Consuming Shadow in the future, so we'll probably see some of them in later videos down the line when I restart the Let's Play of the Consuming Shadow. But yeah, so now we're just gonna play a bit. Just gonna go. I'm gonna show you some stuff. By the way, if I sound a bit, odd, and I'm drinking constantly, it's because, well, basically, I'll explain this while we're driving. Let's go to Bill's church. But, basically, I've been on a course for about 2 weeks now, so I haven't really had much time to do any recording while my internet was down. And so I decided I was just gonna sit down and have Saturday be a big recording day for me. There's fighting on the streets of Almschester. Where's Almschester? There's no way I'm getting to Almschester. Going to Bill's church. But yeah, so I said Saturday would be my big recording day, but I have a sore throat. Here we go. It's not like a massively sore throat, it's just kind of a slight bit of a pain at the back of my throat, so bit iffy. Yeah, so okay. A lot of this text, this is very, yeah, this is what you'd expect. This is very, I believe indeed this is text that you'd already get in the game. Investigate further. Left part of the town, blah, 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 blah. In we go. And just to get me, my mic is blocking my view of the screen. You can see here again, slightly better UI here. It's a lot more detailed. It's got, like, you know, keyboard shortcuts here. It's got a better layout for this. You can actually see exactly what time it is and how time's ticking down. You can see what you got equipped. What's also quite cool is, I don't know if you could do this in the previous build, but you can do this now. You can walk and hit them at the same time as opposed to having to be like, which is very good for dealing with some monsters. It generally does make it it just feels a lot better to actually be able to walk and strike at the same time. Oh, we got a diary page. I'm an idiot. Sorry. Yep, we got diary page 4. Could have sworn I already had diary page 4. Whatever. Look through here. Set of keys. Good, we got the keys right away. The game also apparently has controller support, but personally I wouldn't want to, I think this is going to be a good run, given the fact that we've already got fucking body armor. But yeah, I wouldn't particularly want to, play this game. Fuck. Sorry. I wouldn't want to play this game with a controller. But that might be just because I'm kind of used to playing it with a keyboard and mouse. Yeah, you can play this with a controller now if you want. The syllable Ong had many uses in the language of the ancients, most notably as the last symbol of a notorious dispel, powerful enough to banish a god. Okay, so we got something to do with the ritual. Good. I don't know if this is a- yep, okay, yep, this is an escape. Yep. Nope, don't care. I'll take the sanity loss. I'm not- what's chasing us? I want to see what's chasing us. Oh, shit! Hey! Oh my god, it's a giant fucking head. I'm not staying in here. Oh, fuck that. And to make it even creepier now, there's a fucking ice cream van going by. Oh dear. So that was new. Yeah, but you know, it is essentially the same game, you know, because it's not massively changed. It's just polished. It's just improved. Now, is that in notes? Okay, it's not in notes. That's in spells. Yep, so we got the last thing of the banishment ritual. Now, I'll just tell you this problem right now. What you can delete clues by clicking on them. However, the interface with the notebook is slightly awkward, and I have accidentally deleted clues, and it's really irritating. And I can't really seem to get around it. Like, you have to just be really careful using the notebook, because you will accidentally delete clues. Where are you? A man from the government came today. I don't know what he was saying, but I think he might have been threatening us. We need you here. Great, we just got another random sanity loss. Good. Money from a terrifying cashier. Turns out to come in the cashier with a gun, fling his arm. Use the body armor! Body armor I'm wearing lends me enough confidence to advance upon the robber demanding the gun. Pressure defies a bottle of yourself in my Kevlar, winding me but causing no harm. I can see terror in his eyes as I shrug off the shot, and I'm able to get the gun from his sweating hands. He flees, and I'm able to reward it with both the remaining ammo in the gun and £38 in the impressed cashier. Good. That's another thing. It's kind of changed some of its random encounters. So rather than it just being a complete crapshoot, it has kind of the FTL thing where you can actually just succeed by having the right item, which I quite like. You know, it gives you a certain amount of certainty in some situations. Okay, let's find some supplies. Where should we go? We got like 53 quid here. We can afford that. Prevents broken limbs. Can I please? There we go. It's also, we've got full of this. Let's buy some of these. Okay. I don't think we need anything else, so we'll just head back out. This is a thing, so far as I can tell, let's just heal up that. As far as I can tell, you can't actually get, jobs from towns anymore. For whatever reason. I don't know, I might be wrong there, but that's what it seems to be to me. Let's go to Garal. But yeah, like, the game just looks so much more polished now in its finished version. It's still recognizably the same thing, but it's still enjoyable. And it's a hell of a lot more atmospheric. Like, all the new music is very, kind of, very creepy. I just wanted to say that I love you, and I will support you to the end. I won't tell anyone where you've gone. Aw, I got my... I'm back to top form! This is weird. This is like the first time I've ever gotten some advice to get myself back to top everything. This is good. This is gonna be a... Alms chest would fall into the shadow. You wouldn't know anything about that, would you? I couldn't get that! Sleeper cell in stone shop. Needs clean up sooner rather than later, do it or don't, but if you don't, the town won't be safe for long. Alright, so destination, stones. Okay, we're gonna be going there shortly anyway, but let's check what's going on in Garal first. Oh great, it's full of the shadow. The town is suffering under an infestation of small, scuttling creatures. Too large to be rats, not to mention too aggressive and too organized. It's clear that this is only the beginning of something terrible. I feel that it won't be long before these creatures grow larger and bolder, or someone gets some monstrous infection from a scratch. I must root out the nest before it gets to that point. So a witness has pointed me to a grammar school, which is the first building. Blah, 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 blah. Kids making monsters in his house. New dungeon type! I think there are 6 dungeon types in total, so I think that's a couple more than there were before. So, and this is one of the new ones, is a house, which... And that... One thing I will say, you can tell the house is more recent, because it just looks more impressive. Especially the doors up. Like, you know, the doors to the kind of... it's... Because it's side-scrolling, like, horizontal... Oh, fuck. Oh yeah, that's a thing. You can actually defeat these spitters because you can actually knock their attacks out of the air, which is quite good. But yeah, when this is unlocked, like, you could... Up is relative. Okay, can we see an up door, please? Worshippers, consider a grave insult to draw your sugar symbol in white. Okay, we got a clue. But yeah, there. If I just accidentally clicked there, that would be gone. It's a bit awkward. There. You see? That just looks more impressive than the other room transitions. Just up in this, in these dungeons. Here's a thing, actually. That's another thing I quite like, is the fact that if you you can actually investigate the runes on the walls, and it will actually give you some indication as to what they mean. Which is good, because most of the time you were just kind of stuck trying to guess. Oh, got another, no, that's not another diary page, that's the same diary page. Okay, so far I've unlocked the same 2 diary pages that I unlocked in my first run. Good. Irritating little bastards. I still hate the flies. I still hate them. Hate them with a fiery burning passion. Upstairs. Up is relative, you know. Yeah, fuck you. You know how it works. Up's relative. It's weird. Up on the map. Let's keep moving. I like the presence of the music. I like the fact that there's more music in this build, in this finished build, but I'm not certain whether or not I actually like the music itself. I have never been too big a fan. While the cave dies in the help with human fingers. Because it's associated with the color red. Okay, those are two facts that don't help us right now. Although, actually, that does kind of help, because if Kuz is associated with the color red, then the god that's associated with Kuz is probably all associated with the god that's associated with EU. So those two are probably working together, because there was a red rune of EU that was written as a thanks to a god. So presumably, those two cults are working with each other, and I just walked through the door the wrong way. Good. Great. Congratulations, Mr. Go away. Oh, they're not that threatening. The flies, they aren't the threatening. Neither are you, for being honest. Oh, hello. God. Can I? I think that was what we had to kill. Just this that horrible glob. Symbol Kuz says, powerful enough to banish a god. We've got two of the things from the banishment ritual already. Huh. I really like, I've got to say, like, the house. Whoa! Jeez, what the f- I still don't fully know what those are, and I don't want to know, because they freak me the fuck out. Just, like, horrible, floating, groaning tumors. It's fucking bleh. Ah! Fuck! Fly! Go away! You're not pretty fly for a white guy. Die. Thank you. Dentadol box. 5 quid change. Thank you. Creatures still infest every crack and shadow of the town, but I'm ensured they will no longer breed. A combined effort by the locals will soon be enough to exterminate the remainder. I can move on now. Good. Creepy red light, because it's in the middle of the night. Let's open that. Let's get myself healed up. Cool. Next town that's not shadowed up to the gills, I'll have to stop and get some stuff. Oh yeah, we're going to Stonethorpe. Stonethorpe. Off we go. We got 69 sanity. Another thing I quite like, just a bit of, oh fuck. But yeah, a bit of polish is the fact that the actual area outside of your car window changes depending on where you are. Wind down the wit, yes. A silhouette, madman in the street, seems good. Thick accent, the man's dialect is virtual, but I find the hydrogen leather pouch. Balls of fluid. It is clear he believes he's saying, my mind from the nightmares. Yeah, go on, then he takes my, tosses me a needle and a simple dose of medicine. By the time I've recovered, my lap, he has already disappeared into the night. Okay, free drugs. We've got drugs. Well, free drugs. Not free drugs. We gave him a fiver. Cheap drugs is the correct answer there. Yep, two syringes. But we don't need them because we're doing well. We are, like, we're keeping ourselves together right now. I'm brought to the problematic area and told payment we made once the problem is dealt with. I don't think the locals understand what presence is inside that town. Oh, look, it's a new dungeon. Oh god, it's a new objective, the Dimensional Rift. I don't know how to seal Dimensional Rifts. I think you have to spit two spells at them. I think that's how you seal the Dimensional Rift. When it said that there was like an enemy stronghold, I was kind of hoping I'd be fighting cultists. Okay, I saw that. That was... Oh god, what was it? Okay, yeah, it's... UMT. Awesome! Yes. Closed it before. That would just spit enemies out at you until you close it as well. To my horror, after the priest in the center of the summon, he was shooting every unfortunate gather, mysteriously died. Okay, we got a spell that kills people. That's good. Is it gonna make me run? Okay, it's not gonna make me run. In that case, I'm gonna spend some time doing a bit of an explore. See if there's some enemies around. You know, I'm also gonna just... Yep, never works. That's why I don't use lockpicks, just look around till the phone. Ew, go away. Horrible things. Oh, right. Okay, there we go. The victim. Swellings. Ugh, it's covered in boils. lovely. Ah, a box. Hollow point bullets. Good, my favorite kind of bullets, because what's the point of having armor-piercing bullets when everything you're made of... Everything you're made of? Everything you're fighting is... You just spawned in behind me, you little shit! When have they been able to spawn in behind? He fucking added them spawning in behind me. That fucking asshole. Yes, in the final build, enemies were... Actually, I suppose you can very easily explain how they're spawning in behind you by, like, well, they're entering from, like, the room you were just in, or they're coming in through the other doors. Like, I suppose that's a fine explanation. Yeah, that works. So, do I have a key? No, I just don't have a key. Okay, I can't actually explore anymore, because we just don't have a key. Right. Go away! Stop it! Bastard. Ah, whatever. Don't care, leaving, bye now. People went from outside, determined not to ask questions, £25. Visit the hospital. Actually, no. Turn to the car first. Go here. Take what's left of my supplies. And then go to the hospital. Refill medkit, thank you. What we got? Halves general sanity loss. Yes. Yes, definitely that. I could really use that. Buy a lot of bullets. Buy, yep. Mm-hmm. And suck down some more supplies. Good. Set destination. Where are we going? Let's go to Alms Chest, to that place that we just, like, allowed to fall into hideous disrepair. Let me take another swig here, because my throat's still killing me. Oh, great, an unknown number. This will go well. Hi, I don't know you. A dream told me I should help you. I like to imagine that this is, like, whenever anyone donates to me or my Patreon, it's like a dream told them to. The giant space hippo told me that Tranthor, the gigantic space hippo, told me that I have to help you. I've not seen a single human being since coming off the I have not seen a single human being since coming off the motorway. I'm surrounded by a veritable orchestra of emptiness. Fuck me, an orchestra of emptiness? Jesus. The doors of most of the houses hang open. I have seen numerous lighted windows, but each one only allows a view of a completely vacant room, clothing and bedding scattered messily as if moved aside hastily. The wind is the only sound, and even that howls quietly, as if afraid of waking something up. I somehow doubt that everyone is waiting to jump out from behind the hedgerows and throw me a surprise party. Boo! Bang! Bang! Oh shit, I'm sorry! On closer inspection, I have uncovered subtle clues about a surprise party towards the fate of the people. Scraps of clothing, spots of blood, claw marks near where something has been dragged. All of them lead straight to the front door of the administrative building of the local hospital. Perhaps I am not too late. Perhaps I can find survivors and pull them from the brink. Perhaps if I write it down, I will start to believe it. Good. Hopeful. I like it. Oh, here we go. Yep. Locate 3 missing townsfolk or what remains of them. Will we ever see a living person? Cause, like, we never, like, I mean, the character sees living people, but that's about it. I am wondering how you actually unlock, like, more playable characters. Like, I'm imagining there's either going to be, like, really weird requirements, or you'll find them randomly. Given the fact that the game is, like, a roguelike, I'd like to think that you just find them. I've recovered a small bullet. No. Let's check upstairs. Check all those downstairs areas later. I need to find a key. When written together, the symbols Yu Ang mean to open what is tightly shut. Oh, so now I've got a door opening spell. Yeah. That's good, that's useful. In case, you know, I don't find a key. Because all the doors are locked. In the language of the ancients, the syllable Pti is usually given as a name, but also written as... Pti is associated with illness. Not helpful. Because I don't know... Because I don't know what any of the gods are. So... Well, I know what the gods... No, I don't know what the gods are, actually. So... Ah! Fucking... What? Pti... Did I just... Was that a cultist? Or was that a... That's new! What the fuck? I was not expecting that. Did I just kill a guy?
Oh, you can't find me, you little... Come here! Some kind of survival cache, hollow point bullets, yada yada yada. What's this? Nah, yeah, whatever. Oh, oh, fuck. Hostage pulled a gun, I had no choice. They must have been turned by the Shadow's minions. Fuck. Okay, I suppose that's answered my question. You do find people, and you find them alive. But that one had gone nuts. Oh. Go away, coffer. And a small portable first aid kit. Good, good, useful, good. Moving on. Okay, that's... Cause the tea. Good. I've covered jewelry. Okay, so those are just kind of cult... Whatever they are, they're enemies. Like, I know that. They're just enemies, and I have to match the spell they cast to stop them from killing me. I'm guessing. Hostage, a young woman in officer attire, seems lost in thought and only notices my presence. She nods shallowly and then makes her escape. Is there any more? Okay, we found a person and we saved them. They're alive now. That's really cool. Fuck. Leaving. That's really cool. No. Not even gonna deal with you, cultist. Don't have to deal with you, dark magician guy. That wasn't even real. The strange woman in office was waiting for me at the door. Wanted to know about my mission, so let me just continue instead of wildly reaching into a thick notebook, not unlike my own, and passing me a page of occult text. I thanked her, at which point she suddenly went for a hug, during which she whispered into my ear, "Come to Hurston and bring a pentagram necklace." The White God has no particular interest in our realm. It seems only to consider us unworthy of any action, good or bad, insofar as we can understand the motivations of such a creature. Okay. I think she's... That's probably one of the four characters. Yes, because it's like... Because it said similar to me. And I remember at one point... Stop for a coffee. Varsney's, yeah. But I remember watching one of Yahtzee's Let's Plays where he actually said that he was making a female character for this game. So that's probably who that was. That's a female character. Enter the town. Find supplies. Back to town. There's a hospital. Refill the medkit. Text from a family member. £5. Good. Go to Blesbro. Because I want to find a pentagram necklace. Because I want to be able to play as another character. Because that'd just be fun. Open Ministry of Occultism. Sumley. Yeah, I'll go to Sumley. Fine. I'll help Sumley. And hey, Sumley. I could use the money. And hey, you never know. Sumley might have a pentagram necklace. I don't know what a pentagram necklace would do, like, as an actual effect. Enter the town. Yep, creatures scurrying. Yep, not a threat. Not a threat anymore. Pick it up. I found two bullets. Good. £20. Find supplies. Already got it. this is not good. Yep, get all that. And how long do we actually have to go to Hurston? We have a while, so let's go to Twinbury. You know what? I'll get to Twinbury and then I think I'm going to call it a video. I'm greeted with... convinced that she's possessed by darkness, something I cannot verify. He stabs her through the heart. I have only seconds to act. Restrain the husband! Strength of a lifetime. He uses it to affect my attempt. And before he even knows, plunges a knife into my gut. He's able to run for a smoke. That will require hospital treatment. Great, I'm bleeding to death. Special ammo is expensive. I know that. I've got Hollow Point. Twinbury, please be a functioning town. Fuck. Investigate. Good. I'm bleeding to death. Great. Right! This fucking thing. That's just left. It's just gone. It fucked off. It just flew away. I don't know if I can actually deal with the fact that the enemy just flew away. It just ran off. Alright. Ah, fuck. Hideous vomiting naked man. Stop wiggling on the ceiling. Stop it. Oh good, I got a lockpick. That's good. Another one? There's two of you fuckers in here. Come on, off. Down. Down, Grandpa. Down. What's wrong with you? I know you're mental and old, but that doesn't mean you get to crawl on the ceiling and vomit at people. Giant evil flies, easily stopped by a loping gate and a smack. For some reason. More lockpicks. I don't want lockpicks. I want information. You want lockpicks? I want answers. I want the truth. You can't handle the truth. Okay, we got a toxic mask. So, like, why is it... A sanity effect reversing my controls. I didn't just go stupid. Okay, there we go. That happens sometimes. Ah! Fucking, this horrible fucking thing. Mm-hmm, jewelry. Two locked doors in this place. Monster in here? Ah! Yep, yes it is. Yes it is. Yep. Ow. Okay, good. Ow. The god identified the Kuzrun doesn't appear to be physically survive in our universe, but the threat it poses is very real, but thankfully indirect. Okay, so that's two gods that can't hurt us. Fuck. Leaving. Nope. Not dealing with it. Nope, not dealing with it. I know there's horrible stuff in there, but I'm not dealing with it. Bye! Return to the car, because I'm nearly dead. Hold that. Hopefully that can keep me alive for a short while. Set destination. Burgate? Please let Burgate be a functioning place. Please let it be functioning. 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 Come on, come on, come on, come on. By the way, I like how according to this game, like suddenly... You God fucking no. Castleham. I'm just gonna keep going from place to place until I can find a functioning town. I'm probably gonna die before I get there. Somebody asked me for a lock. I don't have a locksmith kit. Are you in hiding? £6. Thank you. Pull over. Police car pull in front of me. Single eye watched him. Somebody I didn't ask me if one of those taillights is broken. I lie and say no. Whereupon he lets me off on the warning condition that I address the issue. Relief pause for me as I step away. Okay, good. I'm not dead. That wasn't a monster. Castleham. Functioning town. Thank God. Treat bleeding. Refill med kit. Find supplies. Not what I wanted. Oh. Heal. Physician, heal myself. Right. Well, I've been going for 35 minutes. Well, 34 minutes. So, I think this is about it. I really enjoyed the base game, like the beta, the pre-release beta of this game, and this is essentially a more content-rich version of that free base game for a relatively low price, and considerably more polished. So you know what, I can say, without any hesitation, when it's out, Go out and buy it, because this is great. This is an amazing game. But that's, I think that's going to have to be all for me for now. So, I've been your humble narrator, Cyrus Thinker. And as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching that video as much as I enjoyed making it. Well, I say that, I could have been having a really shitty day when I recorded that. You can't tell, and I certainly can't. Pre-recorded message and all that. Anyway, just here to say that I have a Twitter account that you can follow if you want occasional updates of random thoughts from me, and that if you're feeling generous, feel free to donate to my Patreon campaign. Every penny donated there makes life easier for me generally and slowly goes towards me getting a better gaming PC. Well, that's that. It's over. Leave. Now. Now!
Do not seek the Sideways Thinker. Do not seek the Pardoner.